What's going on, everybody? Zen Master back again with another video, and in today's video we're gonna be doing the Grau. In my opinion, one of the best assault rifles in this season. I just love using it just because, you know, it gives me those old vibes. Now guys, if you want to get your gun this type of camo, if you want to get the Damascus Dark Matter Ultra, pretty much any camo, we got a service in the Discord. Make sure you join up. Discord is gonna be in the description. All right, all legit. We already done a couple people. Hey buddy. All right, all right, we gotta go somewhere safe. All right, let's do this recoil test real quick. All right, we're gonna do the recoil test over here. It was a little bit hot over there, so we're gonna do it over here. Now I'm gonna show you guys the recoil without the progressive on, so you guys can understand something about the Grau. All right, let me shoot a couple times, and I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about. All right, wow, that's a lot of recoil. Okay, I shot once. Let me shoot again. Alright, okay, so perfect, right? So as we see here, I shot pretty much the same distance from the start, and you can clearly see here there's a different pattern, alright? So that's really important that you realize there's no way you're gonna get perfect recoil every single time, alright? It's not gonna shoot straight every single time. There's gonna be inconsistency with the Grau, alright? I just wanna let you know that right now, so when you adjust your recoil, you don't try to make it perfect, alright? Because if you make it perfect, you're gonna shoot once, it's gonna look good. The next time you shoot, it's gonna look different. You're gonna adjust it, and then it's gonna be a game where you just keep doing it forever, right? So if you find a decent value, just stick with it. And yeah, the values I'm gonna be giving you are gonna be good, all right? So let's do a quick little recoil test with the progressive on. All right, so let's see what it looks like. Alright, so as you can clearly see, pretty much no recoil at all. I'm going to shoot again. I guarantee you it's going to look different. Let's see what it looks like. So as you can clearly see, the two recoils are different. Alright, it's nothing to do with the script. It has everything to do with the script and also the gun just being inconsistent. You know, the recoil is always different. So let's shoot one more time as well. All right, so as you can clearly see, three different recoil patterns, but at the end of the day, we can't complain when it's like this. All right, the Zen's not going to give you anything perfect. Even the Warzone Pro Pack, it's not going to be completely perfect. We cannot complain with this. All right, so we're going to go into the values real quick, and then I'm going to show you some gameplay. Guys, I really think it's important you watch a little bit of the gameplay just so you understand how the script works. I'm starting to show you like the full bulk footage of my misses, my like fails, you know, my miss shots, because it's important you see that the script isn't perfect, all right? And you can see when I stick, when it doesn't stick, what happens, all right? Anyways, let's get straight into it. All right, everybody, let's get into the script. Now I'm gonna tell you guys this right now. I have some better values coming out soon. Those values will be on the Patreon starting next month, so make sure you stay tuned. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, the 5.3 it's not that good, but we gotta keep working with it, right? Now to begin, we're gonna go through the script, make sure sniper mods are off. I know maybe this isn't important, but it's something that I do, and I really advise you just copy what I do. You know what I'm saying? Try to copy it as much as you can, because I'm getting good results. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, I'm getting good results. I want you guys to get good results. So yeah, also we're gonna have dogs triple off, and we're gonna go into the aim assist. Now you have to use this exact aim assist in order to get the similar values that I'm getting. If you play with the aim assist, my values will not work for you. So let's just keep that in mind. Now we're going to use aim assist tall oval, radius 14, steps 13, dead zone 5, minimum radius 5, boost strength of 13, boost step 7, rumble boost off. Yeah, that's pretty much it for Taylor. And we're going to use bats, sticky size 11, sticky time 10, boost strength 6. Now we're going to go into anti-recoil, guys. Progressive AR, guys, I'm telling you right now, progressive is the way to go. Do not be using legacy, only for a couple of weapons like SMGs. Legacy would be good, but yeah, legacy, rumble, it's not good, it's not gonna work out. So we're gonna use progressive anti-recoil, 31 vertical start, 28 vertical end, 1300 vertical time, 0 horizontal start, negative 5 horizontal end, 1300 horizontal time. And that's it, guys. So in the next couple of days, I'm going to be finishing off the 5.2 spreadsheet, and then I'll probably be starting my videos on that spreadsheet, kind of, because I'm gonna be honest with you guys, the 5.3 is not the best script for the Taylor Drift. I really think the 5.2 is better, but I still need to do some testing to make sure. I just found that the 5.2 was a bit better sticky aim. I am also working on some new aim assist values, and I'll be making videos on it soon. Just stay with me, guys. You know what I'm saying? It's the end of the month. It's getting a little busy, so these next couple of days I might be a little bit inactive, but thank you guys for rocking with me. Have a good day.